welcome to my channel. If this is your first time of coming by here, hello. And if you're a wonderful returning subscriber, hello, hello. Today's gist is about your Nollywood actors, Funke, akindele. Like, I don't even know where how to start this whole story, you know, how to start this whole rant. Or I'll be just telling, like, if actually this is true, it's really bad, you know. So the story that I've been making the round is about a former employee of Funke Akindele, popularly called Jennifer. Her former employee, who happened to be Cassandra Owolabi, if doesn't, former staff of this Funke Akindele, called her out on social media recent, you know. And in the video, she accused the actress of, you know, of physical, emotional and financial abuse, which according to her, she claimed she suffered all this while working with Funke Akindele. Before I fully go into that, just a reminder, please, if after watching this video and you actually enjoyed it, do not forget to join the family by clicking the subscribe button. And also, I will really appreciate it if you like this video after watching it. And also, please, I also want to hear your own comment. So I want to hear your own, you know, opinion about this whole thing I'm going to talk about down at the comment section. So the story is that this lady and some other persons who used to work for her, you know, she had a production scene, mostly called the scene one production, that the lady that is your Nollywood actress Funke Akindele actually subjected them to working almost round the clock. You know, they were meant to work almost barely at least 24 hours. She said they were banned from watching TV, banned from handling their phones. They literally were just working. And I think she was a scriptwriter in the video, which I'm going to put at the end of this video. You make sure you watch it. She said that she was part of, in fact, she actually wrote most of the scripts, or most of the scenes of Jennifer's Diary from season 1 to season 5. And she said after writing the whole thing, if you watch the whole thing, that you won't even see her name anywhere. And she said that is not even it, that what used to actually get to her is the fact that Jennifer purposely, your Funke Akindele, will come at her, you know, come at them, and all she does is actually shout at them. Not just the shouting, abuse them. They even got to the point that she fell sick, you know, and that she went home, only stayed 2 days, came back in her sickness, she was still working. Like, literally, they wake up by 7 and they take up their laptop and they start working. That she doesn't care about how they feel, and at any point when you're not up and productive, that the only thing that Funke Akindele can tell them is to say that they are lazy, that they are fools. She say, think about it, all the whole names in this world, all the bad name calling that she got it. And what actually got me in the whole thing was that she said that if she's doing all these things, she will brag about that. If you go out there and talk, my fans will not believe you. I have the fan base, this one, that one. And I'm like, really? Is this what the celebrity thing? I think it's you. Like, because I know some of you are going to come bash, you know. Some of you are going to come and say some things after watching this video. Those people who are there, you know, fans. But let's drop this whole fan thing. I think sometimes these fans are the ones actually pushing this so-called, sorry, I'm using the so-called, these actresses into what they are doing, you know, giving them they are busy pushing sand under their bum bum, keep it up, and they keep doing what they're doing. Because most of the time, if you go and see when people who come out to actually bash these actresses, you will come to this comment section, you see their so-called fans saying, oh, she doesn't do anything wrong in my eyes, oh, she's always a saint, oh, she's this, oh, she's that. And I'm like, really, have we actually gotten to this stage where celebrities do stuff and it's okay, it's allowed, but if another person does it, no, it's wrong, no, we need to stop it, all those fans need to stop all this thing. And this is not the first time someone is calling her out on social media. There was once a cast crew of her who is Toyo, you know, Toyo baby also called her out, and when she did, everybody kind of like, you know, supported her. And this is someone else coming out again to say almost the same thing. And it's high time y'all all sit up and talk. And this is a lady who, it was obvious, I heard the story that she never attended none of their siblings went for their father's burial. Like, man, I am really disappointed if this is actually what she does. And all this whole fan base things, y'all need to sit up and speak to your so-called celebrities, like those people you fancy, those people you admire, that you can actually kill yourself for. People should sit up and talk to them.
I mentioned the verbal abuse. I did not even touch on the physical abuse. So imagine my surprise when someone else came in my DM, and then she left a very, very encouraging message for me. I'll leave it on the screen as well. And then she mentioned the physical abuse, guys. I purposely did not even mention that in my previous video. But yeah, guys, if you're there, if you've ever worked with her, then you know that people suffer from verbal and physical abuse. No lies whatsoever. But the reason why I left it out was because I personally was not physically abused, but I have witnessed her laying hands on somebody. And it's not just like, oh, you was that. It's like slap that a mother would give to a 10-year-old. Even a 10-year-old, they're like, who beats kids these days? Do you understand? What I can use to summarize this whole thing is that working for her is like an enslavement. Like she rips you off your fundamental human rights, like no freedom of movement, speech, expression, all those things. You drop them at the gate the moment you accept to work for her. Anyways, like, she does these malicious things because she has confidence in her fan base, like huge confidence. So it's like, my fans will never believe this about me, blah 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 blah. Like, so it makes it hard for people to even come out and say, oh, do you know this person is like this? Because already the fans are not even making it easier. Because when I go on Instagram and I see some comments about her, and they're like, oh, like, so can never do wrong in my eyes, she's so perfect, she's so this, and I'm like, you guys don't know how you're falling her into doing more evil to other people. Like, these things make her demoralize people the more. You guys don't know how much insult we have to enjoy in a day, let alone a week, let alone a month, let alone a full year. Like, it was crazy. And then she tell things like, all you do is eat, sleep, and get fat. That sentence usually gets to me, because sometimes I'll just be like, what's the use of eating? Because she's still going to use it to insult me at the end of the day. And then sometimes I'll just be like, I just like, damn it, and I'll eat my pain. You get, it's just so disheartening when someone that a lot of people look up to treats people in a dehumanizing manner. Like, if she was to be a white person, I bet you guys, like, people will come out to say, this is slavery, this is modern day slavery. Like, we're kept in this room